Today we're talking about what web browser is best for Windows XP in 2020. There are many browsers to choose from. Some are very old, others are new, and some I've never heard of before researching this video. So how do we know what browser is best? Well, most actively updated and maintained websites are secure. Saying a website is secure commonly refers to the use of SSL, Secure Socket Layer, and that the traffic is encrypted. If we want to access secure websites, the browser will need to support at least TLS 1.2. TLS stands for Transport Layer Security, which is a protocol designed to facilitate privacy and data security for communications over the internet. A primary use case for TLS is encrypting the communication between web applications and servers, such as web browsers loading a website. The second criteria is how well the browser can render a web page. Modern websites use HTML5 and CSS3, so we will want to test each browser to see how well it supports those two standards. Last but not least, we will want to test the browser's security. Some browsers receive security updates longer than others, and we want the safest possible option for our retro PCs. Starting with TLS 1.2 support, we can cross some of the browsers off our list, namely Internet Explorer, Safari, SeaMonkey, Netscape Navigator, and Opera. Now we can organize the remaining browsers into groups based on the engine they use. Let's change the desktop to make this easier to see. The groups are Chromium, which is developed by Google. Then we have Gecko, developed by Mozilla, followed by WebKit, developed by Apple, and last but not least, well, maybe, it depends on how you look at it, we have Trident, which is developed by Microsoft. These groupings have some gray area, like Lunascape, for example, uses more than one engine. This presentation is for simplicity. Explaining browser engines is an entirely different video. What can be taken away from this is that some engines supported XP longer than others. For example, Mozilla supported XP the longest. So what can we expect? The browsers that use the Gecko engine or forked from Firefox may score higher in the tests we are about to do. To get started with the tests, we can open one of the many browser options available, and in the address bar, type in html5test.com. When the page loads, the banner at the top will give us a score out of a possible 555 points. Below the banner, we have a very long list of test results and how the browser performed. Record the results if you want to, and on to the next browser. Rinse and repeat. Here is a breakdown of how all the browsers scored. Based on the results of this test, we can eliminate Lunascape, Avant, Qt Web, and Green Browser, as they scored the lowest, and we want a browser that can render most web pages normally. On to the security testing. Open a browser, and in the address bar, enter browseraudit.com. This test takes significantly longer than the HTML5 test, so some patience is required for this step. When the test finishes, record the results and move on to the next browser. Here is a breakdown of how well the remaining browsers performed on the security test. There are a few things I found interesting. MyPal scored lower than Firefox in the HTML test and higher in the audit. MyPal is a fork of Pale Moon, which is itself a fork of Firefox. One of the ways Pale Moon diverged from Firefox is by replacing the Gecko browser engine with Goanna, which is a fork of Gecko. Another point of interest is that the UC browser, which uses the Chromium engine, scored highest out of all the browsers on the HTML test, and lower than Google Chrome on the audit. At this point, we can eliminate the Light browser and Chameleon, because they scored low on the HTML5 test and didn't have particularly high scores on the audit. Also, nothing makes these two browsers worth using over the other ones we are testing. An additional test we can do is called the ACID browser test. This test checks a web browser's compliance with elements of various web standards, like JavaScript. To perform this test, open a browser and type in acidtests.org in the address bar. From this page, select the ACID3 test. When the test completes, you should have a screen that looks like the reference rendering viewable by clicking the link at the bottom of the page. I found several browsers fail this test in different ways. Maxthon here shows the message "you should not see this at all" in the upper left corner. Let's try another browser. How about MyPal? The third square from the left should be yellow, and the 99 out of 100 doesn't seem right. I think this one failed too. Here is a breakdown of the results for the ACID test. So what does all this mean? What is the best browser for Windows XP? By the numbers, UC Browser performed the best. However, support for XP has been discontinued, so the browser may not be safe to use long term. The only browser from our list that is actively maintained is MyPal, making it the best option for Windows XP. MyPal is an open source and community supported browser. The current version at the time of this recording is 28.8.1, which was released late January 2020. As mentioned previously, development for MyPal was forked from Pale Moon, which is itself a fork of Firefox. Pale Moon version 26.5 and Firefox version 52 ESR were the final official releases to support Windows XP. One more point to consider is support for extensions. Unfortunately, that wasn't covered in any of the tests we did. MyPal is based on Firefox, meaning that it supports roughly the same extensions as Firefox, with some exceptions. There may be critical extensions you rely on that will only work on Chromium browsers. None of the remaining browsers are bad options, so by all means, stick with whatever browser suits your needs best. Following the outro will be some additional footage from the browser tests. All of the test results will be down in the description. Subscribe for more videos and click the bell so you don't miss them. Thanks for stopping by. See you next video.